Peace and love, Black family. This is the Prince of Pan-Africanism, King Kong Consciousness, International Ifa Tunde, Big Papa, the notorious RBG, International Ifa Tunde, Intercontinental Ifa Tunde. I am live and direct, Philadelphia, right outside of Philadelphia at the Collingswood Cemetery here right outside of Philly. It is the oldest Black-owned cemetery in the United States. I repeat, it is the oldest Black cemetery in the United States of America, founded in 1902. I am here today paying respects to our ancestors. That's right, brothers and sisters. The Prince of Pan-Africanism is at the oldest Black cemetery in America, right outside of Philadelphia, paying respects to our ancestors. Eden Cemetery was founded in 1902, and in this cemetery lies some of our greatest ancestors. In this cemetery lies some of our greatest ancestors, and I'm standing on the ground of one of them. But why am I here today? I am here today, December 18th of 2019, because today is the 154th anniversary. I said today is the 154th anniversary of when the announcement was made by the Secretary of State of the United States of America, proclaiming an end to slavery and the endorsement and ratification of the 13th Amendment. The 13th Amendment was ratified on December the 6th, 1865, after 2/3 of the then existing United States voted to end slavery, with Georgia, the state of Georgia, the state of my maternal ancestors, Black Georgia, became the last state that was necessary to ratify 2/3 vote of the states to push forth the 13th Amendment so it could be added to the United States Constitution. And today is the 154th anniversary of the announcement of the end of the enslavement of Africans in America. And to pay respect to my ancestors, your ancestors, our ancestors, I'm out here with Queen Mother Orisha Oya of the Winds, honoring those who laid down the groundwork so that I could be here breathing today. I will never forget my ancestors, brothers and sisters. So on the 154th anniversary of the proclamation of the 13th Amendment, officially and legally ending physical slavery in America, I stand here. And if you saw the Harriet Tubman movie, if you saw the Harriet Tubman movie, which I don't really endorse because it was nothing but a Black male bash, you said Dr. Umar got some Black and Miles in his pocket. I was going to blow some smoke to the ancestors, but there's so much wind out here, I don't know if I could give the ancestors any smoke. Sometimes the spirit like a little smoke, but be that as it may, you know, my haters like a little smoke. And when we open up that FDMG in Wilmington, Delaware, they're going to get a little smoke. But guess whose grave I'm standing at right now? If you saw the movie Harriet, you remember that the brother who operated the Underground Railroad office in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, was a brother by the name of William Still. William Still, who collected the largest, okay, repository of escaped slave narratives in the entire history of the enslavement of our people. Well, I'm going to show you his grave. I'm going to show you his grave right there. William Still. That's right. The brother who operated the Underground Railroad right here in Philadelphia. When Queen Mother Harriet brought our ancestors from slavery to freedom, they came through Philadelphia and they stopped downtown Center City, Old City. And it was William Still that helped Queen Mother Harriet. And it was William Still that helped hundreds and thousands of other ancestors escape from slavery to freedom. So we are here, William Still, to honor you. We are here, William Still, to pay memory to you, pay respect to you for what you did, risking your life to help our brothers and sisters go from slavery to freedom, Baba. And although they did not accurately portray you in the Harriet Tubman movie, although they misrepresented you in that feminist plot Harriet Tubman movie. We hope our brother Tyler Perry will give us a real William Steele movie. I said we hope our brother Tyler Perry of Tyler Perry Studios will give us a real William Steele funeral. But we not gonna stop there, brothers and sisters. We not gonna stop there. You live with the Prince of Pan-Africanism in the oldest black cemetery in the United States. We not gonna stop with William Steele. Who else we got? Y'all think it's a game. Who else we got at the historic Eden Cemetery? I'm taking you on an ancestor walk. I'm taking you on an ancestor walk right now. I'm taking you on an ancestor walk right now. Who else we got? Uh-oh. We got somebody else right now. Octavius Valentine Cato. Octavius Valentine Cato. This was Dr. King before Dr. King. I said this was Dr. King before Dr. King. This black man was murdered. This black man was murdered trying to help black people register to vote in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He was a major in the Union Army during the Civil War. This brother was murdered October the 10th of 1871. He was shot and killed by a racist Irish man. I said he was shot and killed by a racist Irish man trying to help black people register to vote. That's right, brothers and sisters. He also fought to desegregate public transportation in Philadelphia. I said he was Dr. King before Dr. King, and he served in the Civil War. He served in the Civil War. He served in the Civil War, brothers and sisters, but we're not going to stop there. We're not going to stop there, okay? This is King Kong Consciousness, 154th Memorial of the Reading of the 13th Amendment, Ending Slavery. We've been here 400 years under white oppression. We know we was here longer, but under white oppression, which you are still under, it's been 400 years. 246 is captives, and 154 as half captives. 246 years as captives and 154 as half captives. We're not gonna stop there though. This whole cemetery is filled with ancestors. This whole cemetery is filled with ancestors. Uh-oh, uh-oh, here go another great. Y'all ready for this one? Y'all not ready for this one. Who know the story of the founding of the African Methodist Episcopal Church? Who heard the story of the founding of the AME? Not Moorish Episcopal, not Indigenous Episcopal, not Sovereign Episcopal, African, 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 African Methodist Episcopal Church. And Absalom Jones went to go worship at a white church in Philadelphia. And the white folks told them that they had to go worship somewhere else. They had to move to the back of the church. Black people were not allowed to serve in the front. And they started their own churches. Richard Allen started what would become the largest independent black church denomination in the world, the African Methodist Episcopal Church, and his brother, who you're about to see right now. His brother, who you're about to see right now. His brother, who you're about to see right now, Absalom Jones. Absalom Jones, one of the early black masons, one of the greatest black masons, one of the greatest black preachers ever. He went and he started the St. Thomas Episcopal Church in 1794. That's right, brothers and sisters. And not only that, Absalom Jones and Richard Allen started a self-help movement called the, I'm trying to remember the name of it. It was called the African, what was the name of the self-help movement that Absalom Jones and Richard Allen started, ancestors? What was it called? It was the African Self-Helps, the Free African Society. The Free African Society, not the Free Moorish Society, not the Free Sovereign Society, not the Free Indigenous Society. It was called the Free African Society. The Free African Society. These black brothers were so strong and so powerful that they said we could build our own church. So strong and so powerful that they built the Free African Society, which was Marcus Garvey's movement before Marcus Garvey's movement. It was the UNIA ACL before the UNIA ACL, and they was helping black folks. And not only that, when Philadelphia got hit with a yellow fever scare, not only that, when Philadelphia got hit with a yellow fever scare, guess who came out and saved Philadelphia? That's right, Black people saved Philadelphia. That's right. It was Richard Allen and Absalom Jones and a whole army of other ancestors who helped George Washington live in this city from the yellow fever scare. That's what our ancestors did. That's what our ancestors did. That's what our ancestors did. And guess what? I'm still not done. I could be here all night. I'm still not done. I could be here all night, but King Kong gonna give y'all one more. Can I give y'all one more? I wanna give y'all one more. Can I give y'all one more? Can I give y'all one more? I'm gonna give y'all one more because I got a 1 o'clock interview. I got a 1 o'clock interview, Florida. Jackson, Mississippi, I'ma see you next Thursday, first day of Kwanzaa. Orlando, Florida, I'ma see you next Friday, second day of Kwanzaa. Pahokee, Florida, for the first time. Pahokee, Florida, for the first time. I'ma see you next Saturday, third day of Kwanzaa. Detroit, Michigan. Detroit, Michigan. Once again, I'm ending the Kwanzaa tour in Detroit, Michigan. 2 years later, Charles Wright Museum, Monday, December the 30th. We're gonna close out 400 years of struggle. We're going to close out 400 years of liberation building. We're going to close out 400 years of Pan-Africanism. But I want to give y'all one more hero before I jump on the radio interview. All right. And that is James Fortin. James Fortin was one of the first black millionaires in America. James Fortin was an inventor. He was a sailor. He was also a prisoner of war of the British during the American Revolution. I don't think you heard me. I said he was a prisoner of war of the British during the American Revolution. And his daughter, Charlotte Fortin, y'all should know her. That's the black woman during the Civil War. That's the black woman during the Civil War who went down to South Carolina and opened up a freedom school and taught African children in the freedom school. That was James Fortin's daughter. And his other daughter, Charlotte Fortin, married my greatest Philadelphia hero, Robert Purvis, who is buried in the Quaker Cemetery on Germantown Avenue. Shout out to North Philly. Shout out to Allegheny. Shout out to Erie. Shout out to Ridge. Shout out to Susquehanna. Shout out to Lehigh. You understand? So I'm going to show you this abolitionist who financed out of his own pocket helping Africans escape from slavery to freedom. Right there, James Fortin, 1766 to 1842. 1766, 1842. A prisoner of war of the British during the American Revolution. Not only that, we got another ancestor. We got another ancestor who don't even have a tombstone. We got another ancestor who don't even have a tombstone. He was Chaplain General of the 6th Regiment of the United States Colored Troops. That's right. He was one of those 204,000 black men who risked their lives and many of them losing their lives for us to be alive today. That's right, brothers and sisters. So I'm going to get with the funeral office and see if we can team Pan-African and NIBPA and FDMG, if we can pay and get a proper memorial put right here for our brother who was in the Civil War. Chaplain General for the Civil War, buried right here. Buried right here. So we call out to him and all of those 204 to 220,000 black men and women who risked their lives for the freedom of black folks during the Civil War, including my 3 times great grandfather, George Washington Bailey, including my 4 times great grandfather, Stephen Henry Bailey, including my cousins, Lewis and Charles Douglas. That's tap out. This is King Kong Consciousness, Philadelphia. I'm here. If you're interested in taking Dr. Umar's Philadelphia Underground Railroad tour, if you're interested in taking Dr. Umar Johnson's Black Philadelphia Underground Railroad tour, you will be able to sign up for that. You will come to Philadelphia for 2 days. We're going to put you up in a nice hotel and you're going to tour all the black history of America's first free black city for black folks. I said you could come to Philly and I'm going to be your tour guide. I'm going to dig up all types of black history about Philadelphia, America's first free black city, more than you could ever know. This is the Prince of Pan-Africanism signing out. Donate to FDMG. Cash.me/$FDMG school. Cash.me/$FDMG school. Cash.me/$FDMG school. Or send a check of money order payable to FDMG Academy, P.O. Box 9634, Wilmington, Delaware. I said P.O. Box 9634, Wilmington, Delaware 19809. That's 19809. Don't send 10, send 20. Don't send 20, send 50. Don't send 50, send 100. Don't send 100, send 300. Let's get that school open for black boys. Let's end the game. Let's put an end to it right now. Mississippi, I'll see you next Thursday. Pontiac, Michigan this Saturday, December the 21st. The Prince is in Pontiac. Next Friday, Orlando. Next Saturday, Pahokee. And next Monday, Detroit, Charles Allwright, King Kong Consciousness is Black Power.